Hi everyone, I'm Esther Eckhart from eckhartyoga.com and I want to talk to you today about pain in your groin when you practice yoga. More and more people complain about it and have injuries in that area, and it's not a good place to have an injury, and it's totally unnecessary too. So let me explain why it's unnecessary. If you look at the hips of my lovely assistant here, he has a bony protrusion right here. So that would be in my body here. Yeah. And both hips and the way this, how bony this protrusion is, how sharp it is, the way it points in or points out is different in every human being. It's different from men to women, but it's also different between women. So, so the effect of bringing limbs together is also going to be different for everyone. When we experience pain or pinching in our groins, is mostly around forward bends and twists. So I can't bend the torso forward. So instead of that, I'm going to bring the leg up because I'll break my assistant here. So if you bring the torso and the leg together, at some point, of course, there's soft tissue between all the bones. In my body, there's soft tissue. At some point, this bony protrusion will start to hit the bone of the upper leg. So if there's soft tissue between, it starts to pinch. This hurts my fingers. It starts to pinch the soft tissue and it doesn't feel good. However, if my leg is here, it hits. If I bring the leg in, it will go around it. If I bring the leg out, I can go around it. So if we teach or if we practice yoga in a way that we say you have to bring your leg up in a straight angle and this is the way it has to be, and in your body exactly that bony protrusion points that when you bring that leg straight up it starts to hit, and it's in my case it is, so I can't go further than this without hurting myself. If you feel pressure, something is being pressurized between. Pressure is not so bad, but if it starts to be tingling or painful, you don't want that. So here it for me, pain. So I can do this and bring my leg higher up. I can't do this. I can't go in because, you know, the way my bones are shaped, this hurts me. So I can go here, and then I have to find space around that bony protrusion on this side. It's less of a problem. I can bring my leg up high. Apparently the shape of my bone here is a little bit different than on this side. So even between sides, it can differ. And so you really want to, and you're not going to know, you're not going to be able to look into your body, but you can feel. And again, pain, sharp, tingling, you don't want that. So I'm going to show you regular yoga poses that can bring this up, and alternatives you can do to make sure you work on the long-term health of your hips. So I'm going to put my assistant to the side. Thank you. And one of the poses that is taught a lot is child pose. I personally have to do child pose with my legs apart because then I do not have that bony part ACES, the anterior superior iliac spine, that's the name of that point, pressing into my groin, yeah, into the soft tissue there. And the groin is this area. So if I do this, I'm uncomfortable. I can't go down because it will just hurt me and I don't want to hurt myself. So I put my knees apart and voila, I've got a pain-free child pose. So any teacher that tells me you have to do your child pose with the knees together, I go, well, I can't and I won't because it hurt myself. And that's what you should do. You should never listen to a teacher if it goes against the knowledge and the feedback of your own body. And it's really important to understand also why. So another pose is a lunge. So for example, stepping one foot forward. Now the thigh and the upper body is moving into each other. So for me, I can be here. I can't go deeper without pain. If I can go deeper, if I bring my right foot out If I let my knee turn together with my leg out, then I can go deeper and there is no pain. Yeah. So if I want a real stretch on the front of my left thigh, if that's my objective, is that the functionality of the pose, if I stay here, I can't really get it. If I try and go deeper in this pose, I will hurt myself. So if I just bring that leg out, it may look different, but I work the pose functionally. And as well, if a lunge here with leg straight gets you, you can also just bring it out a little bit. Yeah, it's okay. As long as the leg and the foot point in the same direction, that you keep your knee healthy. And with a twist, this is fine for my body, if I have my leg slightly turned out. But if it's, again, pinching, just put your hand down on the inside and create that space. I'll show you on the other side. You create that space in the groin and then twist. Yeah, so you might not look the part with regards to what the teacher does or the picture in the book or your neighbor, but you look after your groin and the health of your hips, which is much more important. Then we've got Paschimottanasana, the seated forward bend. With my legs together, in this case I can do it, for whatever reason it doesn't seem to hit. But I know people who about here will experience that painful sensation in their groin. So they really shouldn't go any further. The thing they can try and do is bring their feet a little apart, and maybe, like I was showing you, if you turn the thigh around, you might go around where things come together, around the compression. So you could try feet apart. You could try changing the angle of the pelvis by sitting up. I don't have anything here present, but sitting up on a block or a folded pillow or folded blanket. And you can, if that doesn't work, you can also do one leg at a time. So you can place one leg over and see if this works. And you still work the hamstring on one side at a time. And you may not feel the compression in a painful way. And even here, this might work. Again, you go back to what is the function of the pose. The function of the pose of the forward bend is to stretch the back side of the body, the hamstrings. Well, if I'm here and I only feel pain in my groin, nothing is happening in my hamstrings. And then you push and you push and you hurt yourself over time. Why not do one legged and see if that works? Why not bring the legs a little apart and see if you can go around the pinching of the groin? And then, voila, I feel a stretch in the hamstrings. And then another one, for example, is a twist. I get it a lot in the twist, actually. So when you lie down, and I twist and I really try and keep my knees together and I keep it up, I feel it here now. So I try and have something between the knees, or I can extend a leg, or in this case, if I push my knees further back, actually it gets worse. If I bring the knees up, I'm fine. But for you, if you experience a pinching in your groin, maybe you experience it up high with your knees and you don't experience it with the knees further down. So that's something you need to explore and know that there is no right or wrong. There is just your body, the way your bones are structured and shaped and come together, and the way you work with it to find a pose that is functional for what you're trying to do. And that's why it's important in yoga that you know why you're doing a pose, because then you can go and work with alternatives to try and get the same stretch. For example, with a twist, you want to release the spine, and with a forward bend, you want to stretch your hamstrings and the back body. And so all these things are important and make sense. So I hope this will help you from now on to make sure that your groins feel relaxed and healthy during your practice, and that your hips will stay healthy for the rest of your life. Thank you for listening. Enjoy your practice, and know then look for ways to go around any aches or pains and make sure it's still functional. Thank you.